What's happening, everybody? All right, here's the deal. This is what's going on. I'm going to revisit a gentleman I saw, I don't know, maybe a week ago, 5 days. Hard to say. But his name is Steve. Living in his car between the Home Depot and Walmart. And I told him I'd be back in a few days to check on him. And he said, that'd be fine. So that's just what I'm going to do. All right. Stay tuned. I know you will.
Yeah, guys. This gentleman's name is Steven. He's been here for, you know, I guess quite some time. Let's go talk to him. I just visited him. Sometimes the words just, you know, they just don't come out. All right. I saw him last week. So, all right, let's check on him. See what's happening. There he is. How you doing, Steven? I can't hear you, buddy.
Good, fine. How are you?
I'm doing all right. Any progress?
Not really.
No. I told you a few days ago I'd come back to check on you, and that's exactly what I'm doing. You need some food? Are you hungry?
I got plenty of food right now.
You got plenty of food? Okay. Well, what do you think you need most, sir? I know you told me last time it was a, you know, obviously a place to stay. You know, that would certainly be a bonus. Your car is packed, you know, to the max. You know, front to back, top to bottom. But would you like me to take your? I can take your car battery home and charge it and bring it back.
It's got a new battery in.
I mean, so it works right now?
Yeah.
Oh, fantastic. Okay. I thought it might, you know, it might be dead, but
well, it was. Somebody brought me a new battery and put it in for me.
Okay. Well, good. Good deal.
All I need now is some brake fluid, which I hadn't done that yet.
You need some brake fluid?
Yeah.
I can probably find some of that.
I gotta get insurance and stick it in the tag.
Oh, okay. So your plate's expired? Okay. Yeah. Well, they'll get you, that's for sure. They don't skip a beat here, you know. I'm sure I don't have to tell you, but all right. Well, do you have any immediate needs? Like, you know, obviously you said you got food and drink, but all right. Well, I'm just doing a checkup on you, follow up like I said I would.
Appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem. All right. Other than that, you getting any trouble? Anybody harassing you or anything?
No, not really.
Well, when you say not really, that makes me think like somebody did.
Well, there's a guy over here in the black Cadillac. We got into it yesterday.
Oh, the guy parked right behind you in the black Cadillac. All right. Well, boy. Okay. You think you're going to be all right then?
Yeah, I'll be okay.
Okay. All right. Well, Steve, it's good to see you again, sir.
Good to see you too.
All right. I just thought I'd check on you, man. I just wanted to make sure if there's anything I can do for you. You know, I'm just trying. So. Yeah, no, you're 100% welcome. So, you got to be liking this cooler weather.
Yeah, it's helping.
Yeah, except for when it's 2 o'clock in the morning. Yeah. But
I like it when it's just right, not too hot and not too cold.
Yeah. I like the low to mid 70s is fine with me as long as the humidity's low. Yeah. But yeah. It's just the way it is. All right, sir. Well, all right, then I will bid you farewell, and I hope you have a great day. Is it okay if I come back in a few days and check on you? All right, but I just wanted to follow up on you and see how you're doing. So, all right, sounds good, sir. Take care of yourself. Oh, I see the guy in the Cadillac now. He was giving you issue?
He left his car running the other night.
So his exhaust was getting in your car?
He left his car running the other night and the radio blasting and everything. He took off to get some cigarettes for me and himself too. When he came back, he was complaining about the car running. He left it running, I didn't. He tried to accuse me of it.
Wait, he was complaining about your car running?
His car.
Well, why would he complain about his car running when he's the one driving it?
Because he was low on gas. He was trying to tell me that I was the one.
Oh, so he wanted gas money.
I don't know what he did.
Yeah, no, I see what he's saying. You know, just trying to milk you out of a few dollars. All right. Well, I don't know if I'd so much worry about that, but... that's a, you know, I guess a petty worry, you know. He's driving a Cadillac, something or other. Nice car. Yeah. Very nice car. All right, Steve, take it easy, buddy. Good to see you, man. All right, I'll stop by in a few days. Is that cool? All right, I appreciate that. All right, well... just wanted to follow up. So, all right, have a good one. This dude here in a Cadillac. Look at the scar, it's beautiful. Leather. I think every Cadillac has leather just by default. Not sure. I know they got V8s, but all right, whatever. You know, not my business. Kind of sounds like a neighborhood slash argument. You know, that's up to them. They'll sort it out. Obviously, with a car like that, you would think that he's new to being homeless and just hasn't lost the car yet. Well, that's my opinion. You know, don't take that as fact, but if he's been parked there, I can see him in his front seat. He's slunched over, sleeping. Didn't feel it'd be appropriate to talk to him. Seems like he might be a disgruntled type person, but then again, at the same time, I'm not scared. All right, guys, we're gonna sign off. Oh man, got plenty of places to visit today. We're gonna make it happen.